We want to discuss the Bajaj Finserv. It's the top loser on the Nifty after its general insurance business saw one of it in the September quarter. But the company's life insurance arm has been picking up growth. What are the key factors to play? Let's ask the management. Joining us on the phone line is Chief Financial Officer S. Srinivasan. Good morning, Mr. Srinivasan. Thank you so much for speaking to us. First of all, let's get started with the numbers. If you're looking at the numbers, the first thing that I want to ask is in terms of your general insurance business. What has been the impact of the Kerala flood in the second quarter? And are there any one-offs this time around?
See, the Kerala flood's impact on the PBT was about 63 crores in quarter two. The other thing was early in the year, we decided this year that we would tactically do less of crop insurance business as compared to our core business, which is motor, health, personal lines, and corporate businesses. Crop insurance is something we look at it tactically every year. This year, the reinsurance conditions and terms were quite tight. The pricing conditions we felt were not very strong in our preferred markets, and therefore, we took a call that in the Kharif season, we will do less of crop insurance. The good thing is that excluding crop insurance, our core business in health, property, personal accident, and other lines has grown more than 30% in Q2 and 28% for the first half. So growth momentum continues to be strong in our GI business. The Kerala floods were unfortunate in Q2, and typically when catastrophes like this happen, that quarter will look bad, but over the end of the year, it is not something that recurs every quarter. So hopefully we'll be able to claw back the profitability in the next two quarters by doing the right things that we have been doing over so many years. The other thing with the catastrophe is it is something we as insurance companies do not look at it as the loss. It is more an opportunity for us to be with the customers to settle the claims fast. And based on our track record from 2005, Bombay floods, then J&K floods, Chennai floods over the last 10 years, we have built specialized expertise in settling large catastrophe claims in very quickly. So we think this is what customers want, and we are happy that we got an opportunity to deliver on that.
So can anything again flow into the third quarter, or are all the provisions and...
As far as the Kerala floods is concerned, this is what we expect by end of the year. I mean, this is what it is. We don't expect a spillover in Q3.
Okay. So how has the combined ratio, claims ratio and solvency ratio shaped up in this business, sir?
See, in terms of combined ratio, for Q2, it was 97.2%, which is after the effect of Kerala floods. If you take the Kerala floods as a one-off, our combined ratio on the core business would have been 93.6%. So it is still among one of the best in the industry. In terms of claim ratio, again, we had 68.2%, which is not something which is alarming or concerning. And excluding the impact of Kerala floods, it was 65.2%. Our solvency continues to be strong. We are well above the IRDA's requirement of 150%. We are at about 280% plus. So we have surplus capital there to run the business.
So how do you see the regulatory changes around this motor insurance and rising interest rate to have an impact on your business going ahead?
I'll take both separately because impacts are different. See, motor insurance, now we had the Supreme Court order making mandatory 5-year third-party policies for two-wheelers and 3 years for private cars. And with the own damage being optional for 1 year or 3 years or 5 years for private cars and two-wheelers. The impact is that we think the cost of two-wheelers particularly is going to go up significantly, because subsequently there was another guideline for the regulator based on a Madras High Court order that the personal accident insurance for the driver should be hiked from 1 lakh to 15 lakhs. And again, that is again has to be offered for 5 years. So clearly that has a significant impact on the cost of the vehicle. This could have an effect on the slowdown in the number of two-wheelers that may be sold. However, we are well entrenched with a well-diversified distribution mix that has been one of the strengths of our GI company. We deal with motor insurance service providers. We have individual agents selling insurance. So we think we are reasonably well poised. Coming to the subject of interest rate increases, for the insurance business overall, I would say they are positive for the GI business, because we have a shorter duration asset portfolio on our investment side, and as they mature, we'll be able to reinvest them at higher rates if the interest rates do go up. Similarly, in the life business, it is good for the guaranteed businesses. However, for the shareholder funds, again, the new cash flows that come in should be invested at a higher rates. The existing book, obviously, will have to mature and will have to reinvest after that time. So overall, I think it is positive for the insurance industry.
Okay, so coming back to the business, as far as your life insurance business is concerned, how was the premium growth in the life insurance business, and can you tell us about the individual APE growth?
Yes, individual APE growth for the quarter was 24%. The momentum which we have seen over the last 8 quarters has continued in this quarter. One big change we made about 9 months ago was to reduce our dependence on ULIPs. We were doing some amount of traditional business, but we wanted to have a more balanced product mix with a targeted 60-40, 60% ULIP, 40% traditional. We have almost reached there at 61-39. This has a significant impact because, A, the markets have corrected now, and we have seen in the first 6 months that the non-bank-sponsored companies, which do more of traditional business, have actually outpaced the bank-sponsored companies in terms of growth rate of individual premium. And over the next 6 months, we are well poised, whichever way the market turns, we have either traditional or ULIPs. So we should be able to, I mean, our target is to grow faster than the market.
How do you see the market share shaping up in the life insurance business going ahead?
Yeah, well, I mean, in the short run, market share can be volatile. But we would think that over the next 3 years, we would want to improve our market share from where we are today, especially on the individual rated premium side.
On the insurance business, are you looking at any new partners as of such?
Partners in terms of...
No, there were talks about some bit of partnership with Alliance in the insurance business, and probably...
So Alliance continues to be our sole partner for insurance business. They take a keen interest in the India business. We will not be having any changes.
Any plans to list the insurance business separately?
In the foreseeable future, no. Both companies are sitting on significant solvency surpluses. The companies don't need money as such. So therefore, we are not looking to list the companies in the foreseeable future.
Okay. My final question, we spoke to Rajiv Jain yesterday extensively on Bajaj Finance. So what's your view on the lending business?
On the lending business, the way we see it is, our lending business, as you know, is well diversified. We have a significant proportion coming from consumer businesses. We have our consumer B2B business, which is very short term, between 1 month to 8 months. We also have some part of our SME business, which is not more than 2 to 3 years. And we have a very strong ALM framework where at each bucket, 1 year, 1 to 2 years, 2 to 3 years, 3 to 5 years, our liabilities are more than the assets. And we maintain a liquidity surplus of about 7,500 crores. This is something we voluntarily started about 5 years ago. And depending on the market conditions, it varies between 4 to 6% of our AUM. We also have diversified our liability book. Today, we have 13% of our book coming from deposits, retail and corporate. So as a diversified NBFC with a consumer focus, with a shorter duration of the assets, and with a strong franchise, we do not foresee a significant problem. If at all there is a problem in the market, it would only, we feel, in the long end of the market, because as interest rate cycle turns, people are reluctant to lock in money at lower yields for long term. So they wait for the interest rates to pan out. But typically this doesn't last for more than a year or year and a half. So the short end is good. We have been able to raise money in the last 3 weeks itself, more than 5,000 crores in BFL and another 2,500 odd crores in our housing finance company. So we think BFL is well positioned in terms of both risk and obviously there are no credit issues on the asset side.
Okay, Mr. Srinivasan, we leave it at that. Thank you so much for speaking to us on Bloomberg.
Thank you.